quake prediction falls flat. Details at 11.
Oh, I'm sure he's going to like it. It's so soft. Yes. What's it made of?
Virgin wool.
I've always wondered, how do they know which sheep are and which sheep aren't?
Well, anyway, two more presents, and my Christmas shopping is done.
Oh, I still have lots to do. And I keep putting it off because I dread going into the stores with people pushing and shoving and hanging all over me.
Oh, I don't mind that. It fills a void since the passing of Lars.
Well, I guess I'd better get started pretty soon because last night, Jonathan and I decided to go away for the holidays.
Oh, Audrey, how nice. Do you have reservations?
Oh, no, we really want to go. The question is, we can't decide where to go.
Oh.
We've got it narrowed down to either Hawaii or Mexico. Jonathan is down at the travel bureau now getting the tickets. He said he'd make the decision when he got there.
Oh, here he is.
Ah, hello, dear.
Hello, Hawaiians.
Oh, well, it looks like Mexico for us.
No, Audrey, I decided on Hawaii. I heard the call of the islands, and I could not resist. I was stationed in Hawaii during World War II, and it was particularly beautiful.
Oh, Jonathan, there'll be other wars just as beautiful. I really want to go to Mexico, dear. They say that the water is so clear that you can read the labels on the beer cans lying on the bottom.
Audrey, if you'll say yes to Hawaii, I promise you a week of rapture, passion, and ecstasy.
Oh, and what will you be doing?
Audrey, have you started packing?
Oh, no. I guess I'd better get started.
Did you get my plane tickets?
Yes, Mother. Here they are. How do you like my shirt?
How would you like a Hawaiian punch? Did you order my special diet lunch?
I did, Mother. Burritos, chili, and beer.
With the extra hot sauce?
Yes, Mother.
Well, did you get me a place in the smoking section?
You don't smoke.
I do when I have that extra hot sauce.
Are you going away too, Mother Dexter?
Yes, Arthur and I are going away for the holidays.
Oh, where to?
Well, I'm taking him back east to meet my mother. She wasn't able to come out for the wedding.
You're... Mother?
She's 104, and she's in terrific shape. In fact, she's so young-looking that a lot of people take us for sisters.
Hi, Phil. Hi, Mother Dexter.
Oh, Beth. Oh, I'm so glad you're home for Christmas.
and Mother Dexter and Arthur all going out of town for the holidays.
Oh, looks like it's going to be pretty empty around here this Christmas.
Oh, I don't mind, Bess. The important thing is that you're home. Oh, we'll have such a wonderful time. We'll put the lights up outside and we'll hang the stockings on the mantle.
Phil,
Oh, Bess is going to be the best Christmas ever. Don't you worry, dear. It won't be lonely around here at all.
Phil, I don't know how to tell you this. I mean, I really feel bad, but I made arrangements to go skiing over Christmas vacation.
Why, Bess, I think that's a fabulous idea.
You do? You mean you're not disappointed?
Disappointed? Why should I be disappointed? Oh, Bess, I can just see myself now speeding down the slopes, the wind whistling through my pierced ears.
Mom, parents aren't invited.
Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry. When I made plans to go away, I had no idea everyone else was going away, too. I hate to see you have to spend Christmas alone.
Oh, don't worry, Bess. You won't see it. You'll be away having fun. Besides, I still have my friends at the office. I can celebrate with them. I'm sure we'll have a big party, and that will be my Christmas.
Oh, I've heard stories about those wild parties. Your boss isn't the kind that would try any hanky-panky with you, is he?
Dan, certainly not.
Maybe you'll find a better job. Right?
Good morning, Leonard.
Good morning, Phyllis.
Isn't it a beautiful time of year? There's something about the days right before Christmas that is so wonderful. Santa Claus is in every corner. People doing their last-minute Christmas shopping. Everybody smiling and wishing everybody a happy holiday. And those marvelous displays in the store windows. I saw the cutest little mechanical elf this morning in one of them. Oh, he was just adorable. He was helping Santa make toys.
Your arthritis acting up again, Phil?
By the way, I have presents for each of you, but I'm not going to give them to you until the party.
What party?
The office Christmas party. Don't you usually have one?
Not since I worked here.
Why not?
I don't know.
Well, maybe it's because we're public servants and supposed to represent all the people. If we started celebrating Christian holidays, it might look like we were prejudiced against pagan savages.
Why shouldn't we have a party? It'd be fun.
Of course it would. Let's do it. I'll take care of everything. I'll get the food and the drinks and the decorations.
Can we have an artificial tree?
An artificial tree?
Oh, yes. Oh, what memories that would bring back. Every year, Mom and Dad had an artificial tree. Just wouldn't seem like Christmas without the smell of plastic in the air.
Okay, then it's decided. When should we have it?
Seems like as good a month as any.
Okay, tomorrow afternoon.
Great.
Oh, it'll be wonderful. We'll all get together in the spirit of brotherhood and goodwill toward all men.
Who should we invite?
Oh, everybody on the whole floor, except Republicans.
Miss Judge.
Yes, sir, Dan.
Can you type up this resolution for the new juvenile detention center?
I'll type it up right as soon as I call the caterers.
What cater, Lindstrom?
Oh, the cater for the party. I forgot. You don't know. We're going to have a Christmas party tomorrow afternoon.
Well, not here, we're not. We have too much work to do.
But Dan, this party means a lot to me.
I'm sorry, Lindstrom, but problems just don't disappear because it's Christmas. Look, I feel from the moment I walk in that door to the minute I leave, I'm being paid by the public to do a job, and that's just what I have to do.
Well, come on, Dan. I'm sure other politicians don't feel that way. Well,
maybe not, but I feel that one man can make a big difference.
You don't have to tell me that. I'm a widow. Well, that's beside the point. See, Mother Dexter and Arthur and Jonathan and Audrey are all going away for the holidays, and Bess is going skiing, so I won't have anybody to celebrate Christmas with unless I have this party.
Well, I'm sorry your family's running away from home, Lindstrom, but there's not going to be any party, and that's that.
Girls, I just got this great idea for party hors d'oeuvres. Little reindeer made of chopped liver.
Party's off, Leonard. Dan says he has to work, so he canceled the party.
Dan canceled the party?
Just because he's got a lot of work to do, nobody gets a party, big bully.
Well, we'll just see about that.
Leonard, what are you gonna do?
Harriet, You're right. Dan is a bully, and there's only one language a bully understands, and that's force.
Come in.
No. You come out.
What is it, Leonard?
Dan?
Why'd you call the party off? Leonard, as a fellow member of the Board of Supervisors, I fear you realize that we are paid servants of the public. To forsake those duties for even a few hours, I feel would be dishonest and unjustifiable. So that's why I called off the party.
Well said, big fella. Thanks for your time. Man can't be reasoned with.
You're afraid of him.
Yeah.
Afraid? Me? Afraid? Ha ha.
So why don't you stand up to him?
Harriet, when it comes to taking a stand, nothing is firmer than a marsh. Dan, Len Marsh, now hear this. We are too having a party, so there.
That's what you think. Leonard, I've been working day and night in a project for months, and I've got only 2 days to finish it.
Well, I'm only thinking of you, Dan. You're driving yourself too hard. Look at those lines on your forehead. Two more and you could screw your hat on.
Leonard, I've been thinking this over very carefully, and there's not going to be any party.
May I remind you that half of this office is mine. And if I say we're going to have a party, there's nothing you can do to stop me.
You know something, Leonard, you're right. There's nothing I can do to stop you. I'll tell you what, you can have the party.
We can?
Yeah, you can have the party on your side of the office. And on my side, we work.
Fine.
Fine. Fine.
Fine.
In celebration of the holidays with my own family at Tucker Inn.
Sarah, you made Grandma's Black Forest cake.
You know, I haven't had that fresh taste in years.
Made Grandma's topping, too.
Mm-mm. It's Cool Whip.
It's not Grandma's homemade topping.
Taste it.
This fresh taste reminds me of
Grandma's homemade.
Grandma would have been proud of you.
Cool Whip non-dairy whip topping tastes as fresh as homemade.
Mrs. S. Claus for Jell-O brand gelatin.
Today I'm going to show you how to make a holiday dessert that's so quick you can make it anytime. Place dark sweet cherries in glasses. Dissolve cherry flavor Jell-O gelatin in your blender. Add crushed ice and blend. Pour and chill, and it layers all by itself. Here you are, dear.
See this recipe in December Women's Magazines. For holiday desserts any day, start with Jell-O gelatin.
Ah, it's a great party, Leonard. Hey, where'd you get this electric train?
My dad gave it to me for Christmas when I was 8 years old. I used to let my little pet turtle ride on it. I'd dress him up as a hobo and kick him off in Kansas City. It used to take him a year to walk home.
Ah, Phyllis, are you sure you can't join us? We're really having a lot of fun.
No, Harriet. Dad said there's no Christmas party on his side of the office. And I'm on his side of the office.
Oh, come on, Phyllis. It's Christmas.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. David Frost nipping at your nose.
Okay, Lindstrom. It's the first part of my report. Type it up as fast as you can.
Whatever you say, Supervisor Lindstrom. Merry Christmas.
Hi! Merry
Christmas. There's anyone who ever needed a drink, Phyllis, that's you.
Gesundheit.
No, Harriet, I'm not allowed to go over there.
No problem. We deliver.
That's pretty powerful. What was it?
A lady finger.
What's in it?
Vodka and nail polish.
Yes,
sir.
get those construction statistics for me?
Yes, Supervisor Valenti. Construction costs in the Bay Area have risen 62.9% in the past 4 years, as opposed to a national increase of 53.6%.
Thanks, Winston.
Conductor,
415 is coming through. Next stop, Lindstrom.
Hey, when are we going to hang the mistletoe?
Hang is too good for it. Let's shoot it.
Lindstrom. Where's that testimony on correctional institutions I want to use in my preamble?
Oh, that was Dr. Margoli's testimony before the Senate Health and Welfare Committee. You'll find it in the Congressional Record, March
13,
1972.
Right.
How'd you know that?
Paul Lynn said it on the Hollywood Squares. If you'll excuse me, I have to work now.
How's it going? Any problems? How long do you think you'll be? Good.
Supervisor Valenti. It's the mayor.
Good, I'll take it in my office.
He'll take it in his office.
Lindstrom, I'll need the file on the earthquake safety standards.
I'll have to go over there.
I'll just make sure you're just passing through.
Supervisor Valenti, you will find it divided into three categories. First, you have 1965 through 1968, the second through 1969 through the present, and the third part is the prospectus. You'll find it cross-indexed with the insurance costs.
All right, thanks, Lindstrom.
Mm-hmm. You're very welcome, Supervisor Valenti.
Oh, by the way, Lindstrom, I want to thank you for working under these conditions. I know how difficult it was for you to be to concentrate with that party going on.
Party? What party? Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a train to catch. I mean, after I finish work.
Phyllis, you look like you could use another one.
Oh, thank you, Harriet. To you, Harriet. My dearest and nearest friend. And to you, Dan.
Lindstrom, would you add this paragraph to the first section?
Certainly, Supervisor. Yeah.
By the time you finish that, I'll have the last section ready for you.
Sir. Say, what kind of party is this anyway? I didn't hear any Christmas carols.
Oh, I know. Christmas carols.
Hey, that's what's being great idea.
We'll start with Deck the Halls. Ready, begin.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. La la, take the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la. Don in our gay apparel. La 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 la.
Finish, let the angels hear it.
Toll the ancient Yuletide carol. La 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 la
la la la. Paragraph three.
Lindstrom. Come into my office. I want to have a little talk with you right now. Tristan, what do you think you're doing out there? Did I give you specific orders that you were to work today? Didn't you tell me yes, Mr. Valenti? Whatever you say, Mr. Valenti? And do you think the city is paying you to get bombed when there's so much at stake here? That's deceitful, Lindstrom. It's downright deceitful.
Will that be all, Mr. Valenti?
Yes, that'll be all.
No, it won't. Sit down.
I am sitting.
Oh. Dan, you're a very nice man. You are fair and conscientious and kind. But you are also the biggest boob I ever met in my life. I'm not saying that just because you don't want to go to that silly party out there. That party's not important. What is important is that this is supposed to be a time for joy. And you don't seem to care about that. If this were 2,000 years ago, and an angel appeared and said, "Come to Bethlehem and celebrate the birth of the Savior," you would have said, "Sorry, I can't make it. I gotta work tonight." Christmas means happiness and giving and love. And if you don't understand that, I feel very sorry for you. Might as well have this.
What is it?
Your Christmas present. Merry Christmas.
Gus, are you all right?
I just want to go home.
Lindstrom?
What is it?
I want to thank you for the present.
I made it myself.
I kind of figured. Lister, one more thing.
What is it?
Can I come to your party?
In that?
Revlon introduces a new lipstick. Revlon introduces a new lip gloss. Revlon introduces a new lip conditioner because you want your mouth to be soft, smooth, and moist wherever you are. Revlon introduces Formula 2, the only lipstick and lip gloss in one. Colors, conditions, and shines in the very special colors you can only get from Revlon. Formula 2, the only lipstick and lip gloss in one. New from the Revlon Research Group.
Many adult headaches start with muscle tension. Fatigue, noise, smoke can make muscles tense, press on sensitive nerves until muscle tension headache. Take Anacin. Compared with ordinary headache tablets, Anacin has 23% more pain reliever, plus an extra ingredient. Anacin relieves muscle tension headache fast, and millions take Anacin with no stomach upset. Adult strength Anacin for pain of muscle tension headache.
Oh, Beth, I'm so
glad you're having fun skiing. Oh, I guess I'll just turn in early and wake up in the morning and open the presents you all left me. Well, as you know, we always open the gifts Christmas morning. I just don't think it would be right to open them Christmas Eve. Well, thank you, Bess, for calling. Merry Christmas. I miss you, too.
It's a case of sleepwalking.
I don't sleepwalk. I mean, I never have.
How do you know?
You may have even performed surgery in your sleep.
Voice of experience.
Look, there's no reason to make a big deal out of a little sleepwalking.
I agree. And believe me, I wouldn't if it were happening to anyone else.
It's tension. You've been working too hard and you're not sleeping.
Frankly, I think I'm pregnant.
Tuesday at 9, 8 Central.
The nicest way to start a day is with fruit and cereal. Until the fruit's all gone and there's nothing left but cereal. So smart fruit and cereal lovers eat Post Raisin Bran. Post mixes wholesome wheat and bran with so many plump, chewy raisins, you can get fruit in every spoonful, right down to the last spoonful. And if you're a fruit and cereal lover, it's never too late to learn. Post Raisin Bran, the fruit and cereal lover's cereal.
Mr. Maytag, repairman.
I'm coming.
Help. Old lonely.
Hold on.
Help. Help.
I'd go anywhere to fix a Maytag.
Oh, what a dream. But I'm exhausted. I better go down to the shop, get some rest.
Not all Maytag repairmen are this lonely, but we're trying. Maytag, the dependability people.
A boy's adventures along the Mississippi, they're all captured in Mark Twain's Tom Sawyer. See the exciting conclusion tomorrow at 8. 1 hour from now, Leona's feelings about Julie's death and Helen's feelings about her lusty drama coach make for compelling drama on Executive Suite.
Good news.
I got the job.
Walter, we're as excited about this as you are.
I'm not excited about this.
Walter.
Then, reaction to Charlie's revealing magazine interview.
Wasn't it sensational?
Yes, indeed.
Maud and All's Fair.
Tonight, starting at 9 on CBS.
Introducing four fine citizens. The citizen of the month, the LC digital watch that gives you the month and the date. Our new ladies citizen digital watch. And citizen of the day with the month, the date, and the day. And the first citizen LC digital alarm watch. They all give you continuous readout. Time's up. Get it? Time's up.
Citizen watches are available at the Broadway stores in the fine jewelry department.
I like simple things. I like riding bicycle. I like blueberries. Oh, yes, I love blueberries. So when people sing that Catherine Deneuve is a mirage, I smile. I'll tell you a secret. Everything delightful in life belongs to both of us. Like Chanel No. 5 perfume or the cologne and spray cologne. We have no words for these delights. We know what it is. Chanel.
Available in the cosmetic department at all May Company stores. Citizen mob arrested in L.A. con game film at 11.
Lady Godiva was a freedom rider. Anything but tranquilizer.
Right on, mob.
Phone's working.
Hey, I see your son uses that funny blue stuff.
AIM?
Yeah, my daughter tried it, but I said, no way. Gotta use fluoride. Fluoride fights cavities.
AIM has fluoride. AIM fights cavities. It's a gel.
I like it.
Yeah, my kid likes it better, too, but that's...
Well, if she likes it better, she may brush longer. I know Bobby's getting good checkups.
Good checkups? That rings a bell. We'll use this AIM.
Take AIM against cavities.
Machine's good as new.
So's my Victrola.
Grandpa, you're worse than the kids. Your jacket.
Just a little oil.
And a lot of pre-treating.
Don't pre-treat. Use concentrated oil with bleach, borax, and brighteners.
Oily dirt needs pre-treating.
Well, no detergent gets out everything. But concentrated oil has extra cleaning power.
To get out oily dirt?
Better than other leading detergents.
Joni, it's clean.
The oil's gone.
Concentrated oil concentrates on cleaning.
Yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep.